Bosco, you have been on international stages and you have met a lot of people and networked with a lot of people or seen them. So, in your experience, what tips you have for job seekers who are not used to going to networking events or they are shy when they go to an event? What can they do to be prepared?
Yeah, it's a good question. I think, there are certain things that are very important. And I feel like when I first got into business, I made the classical networking mistake. So let me start off with what you shouldn't do. And the classical networking mistake is to network with an intention, and that's the problem. Many people who are networking aren't necessarily genuinely connecting with you. They're just trying to get their point across. They want to have, a quick response. They want to take control of the conversation, and they want to take the conversation somewhere where there's a purpose and there's an outcome. And typically it's a sales pitch. And that's one of the biggest mistakes that you can make. And I know this because when I first got out into the industry, I was so excited and I'm so eager to do well with business that I couldn't just, I was excited to tell people what I was doing and how I could help them. But I made the classical mistake. And that mistake was I wasn't listening to the other person. And so, when you're listening with purpose, you're listening with eye contact, but more importantly, you're listening without allowing your mind to process. Because here's the problem, when someone else is speaking, you can't get distracted. Your mind is processing more words than the person speaking to you. So the most important tip when it comes to networking is slow down, make eye contact, and genuinely listen to what they're saying, and then respond with questions or statements based on that conversation. Don't go in with an agenda. Some people don't want a sales pitch. Some people are there not to network. Some people are there just because they're part of an event. So know your audience, and not everyone is your customer. Not everyone is your fan. Some of these people are connected to some amazing people, but you have to build on the connection before you can get them to trust on you. So I feel the most classical mistake, and I know this, as being on TEDx Stanley Park, I've been fortunate to speak around the world. I've spoken in Utah, spoken in Australia, I've spoken in Asia, I've spoken in, different parts of North America and Europe. And it's the same language. It's not the language of networking, it's the language of connecting. So the most important tip I can give for you is become a good listener.
I totally agree with you. Whenever I go to any event, I always have intention of listening to them, as you've mentioned. And usually I ask them, what's your intent behind attending this event? Or what are you want to get out of this event? So that gives you an idea about the person and listen to them and then interact from there. And then don't do sales pitch. I hate those sales. You're not there for doing sales and you are there to building relationship. And of course, after you meet, follow up with them on LinkedIn and then build a relationship from there.
Here's another thing too, and here's a default thing that people do. People love to shove business cards, and so they go to these networking events, they've barely told you who they are, and they've shoved you a business card. And I have a golden rule. I connect with people digitally. I have business cards, and sometimes I will give a business card if it requires us to do a follow-up. But the business card only comes out, or I ask for a business card if I'm meaning to follow up, if I'm meaning to have an actual business meeting, or we need to set up a future appointment or a conversation. So, when you're giving out business cards, make sure that you're giving out business cards to people that actually are going to do something with it. If the business card is just going to sit on a shelf, you're just bringing clutter and that energy into your house that you don't really need, or your office that you don't really need, right? So at the end of the day, connect with purpose. Don't just shove a business card.
That's a great tip. Thank you for that, Bosco. And for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips in terms of networking, please leave it in the comment section. And tune in tomorrow for my final question with Bosco.